Welcome back to the Team Impact Gala. Saul Kumin, co-chair of the gala, now joining us as well. So how did you get involved with Team Impact?
Gosh, I've known Dan Kraft for a while, and Jay Kalman's son played lacrosse at Hopkins, where I played, and about maybe 8 years ago, when he was going to Hopkins, 7 or 8 years ago, someone introduced him to me and said, "Oh, your kid's going to play there, you got to meet Saul." And so we started spending time together, and he introduced me to Team Impact, and I've been on the board for maybe 4 or 5 years. I'm the vice chair now, and I've been loving it, so
okay.
It's great.
And what is it about the event in particular that strikes a chord with you?
Well, I think it's a great event to bring people to that don't really know the organization. You know, they sit down and listen to the presentation, and people are just blown away with the reach and the effect that it has on so many people, right? You know, when you describe what Team Impact does, I think it's pretty obvious the effect that it has on the child that is, you know, not well. I think what you realize on nights like tonight is the impact that it has on the teams. So the reach is enormous, right? Because you see these athletic teams that really get to know these kids, and just the reach that it has, the effect it has on so many as it goes through, and you know, the NCAA really.
So Saul, I've only been involved for a relatively short period of time. I go way back with Jay and Dan. We went to college together. So I'm learning more and more about the number of people that are actually affected and impacted. Like, for example, I just found out a little while ago about the fellowship program, which effectively is students at these schools who are affiliated with Team Impact through the fellowship program and effectively serve as a liaison to these schools and help facilitate the relationships that then come to exist between the teams and the kids who obviously have special needs in any way, shape, or form, and in sometimes life-threatening illnesses. So it feels like this is so good on so many levels to provide effectively internships for kids, really kind of opportunities for kids who are playing sports to put life and their competition in perspective, let alone for the children who are being probably benefiting most from the entire experience. And I just, that has to have been, I would imagine for you, I don't know how much of that was a surprise that came to be or whether it was an objective from the beginning.
For me, it was a surprise. And I think I'm still blown away, honestly, consistently about the effect that it has on such a wide reach of people. You touched on, you know, some of the people that it affects. You know, when you talk to these athletes that are on the teams and, you know, especially the ones that are maybe the captains that really get to spend a lot of time with these kids, they learn so much about how lucky they are, about empathy, about, you know, complaining about having to go for a run at 6 a.m. or a lift when – you know, their Team Impact teammate might be going through chemo treatments, and you see what that does, and it gives them perspective, and it's just unbelievable. I mean, I was down at Johns Hopkins last week, and just talking to the kids on the lacrosse team, you know, about their Team Impact kid, Kyle. I mean, you know, it's their eyes light up. I mean, it's their teammate. They're so proud. I just watched them, you know, beat Maryland tonight. The game was at 4 o'clock. And, you know, you see the way one of the first people after the game, they all ran to him. They brought him out on the field. I mean, it's, you know, he's a part of the team. And that is, it's incredible.
It must mean something for you, too, to have the program connected with your alma mater, right?
I love it. Yeah. I love it. And it's a great play. It's a great way to raise money from people. They realize, you know, you find people that played sports at different places. And you you obviously care about your alma mater. You care about the teams that you played on. And then to see that these kids are getting this experience, it's incredible.
So before I let you go, just how long now have you been affiliated or connected?
I think I've been, you know, probably been to this gala 6 or 7 times.
Yeah.
I've maybe been on the board 4 years. It's my second year as the vice chair. So, I've been spending a lot of time. I love it. I mean, the board's great. It's a really good group of people. Everybody just care about the kids, care about the organization. You know, trying to raise money a night like this so you can, you know, you can have more matches, you can
sure.
grow, you can, you know, you can just, the goal is to try to get this, you know, to every sports team in the country and every division down the road, and we're well on our way.
And even in the last, you know, 6 or 7 years, because I think Team Impact's basically twice that old, right?
Yep.
We're talking about 13 years. You've seen a lot of growth. I mean, again, it's got to be a good feeling, I would imagine.
It's awesome. The biggest thing has just been outside of Boston. I mean, this was, as you know, from Tufts and, you know, from your background, it started with a bunch of Tufts guys that had a great idea, and it was a very Boston-centric organization. And one of the things that's happened over the last 2, 3, 4, 5 years is trying to make it, you know, national and putting people on the ground in other parts of the country and being able to raise money from other parts, being able to get into institutions across the country, and really making it a national organization. And I know you just spent some time with our new CEO. We're excited about, and we think that, you know, he's going to be able to help lead us there.
Well, listen, thank you for joining.
Anytime.
Right. Great. Pleasure to meet you.
Great
really
to meet
happy
you.
To be a part of it.
Thanks for the time.